Hi, my name is Yiyu Chen. I'm a building performance engineer at IESVE. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick demo of using the parametric tool that we developed for parametric energy analysis in IESVE. So without further ado, I will just get started. So I have a simple box model open here. It's a preliminary energy analysis that we are doing for one of our projects. We have assigned some generic window to wall ratio, generic envelope constructions, internal loads, and HVAC systems. So this will be the model that I'm using for this demo. So we have pushed all of our scripts to this VE Python scripts folder navigator. So today we're going to be running these three modules. So the first step to run the parametric analysis is to open or click on this create construction.py. So this is going to open a user interface for you to enter envelope thermal performance, performance values for various envelope types. You'll be doing that for the base case, and you will also be defining the parametric max and min values, which will define the boundary of your analysis. You will also be defining the number of steps to run. So this is going to determine how many measures you will be running for each parameter. For example, if you have three steps here, it's going to insert a third value between the max and mean, and in total you will be having three measures for the roof view factor. The same thing for the rest of the envelope components. Hope that makes sense. So I will just be populating some numbers in here. Okay, and I will just give it a name. I will just call it round one. So once all the values are input here, you can hit submit, and that's going to create construction based on the numbers you input in here. And also it's going to create two JSON files that will be saved in the content folder, which will be used in the next step. So I'm just gonna hit submit, and you can see how it's creating constructions. It's just gonna take a second. Okay, so that's all done. So before we do the next step, let's actually go check to make sure all the constructions are created properly. So you can see the ones that just got created by the parametric tool is going to have param at the beginning of the construction name. You can also see how the name has the U value that you entered for each measure. So let's go check them. So this one is supposed to have U value 0.045, which is 0.045, so that's correct. And check another one, 0.151. We're getting 0.151, so that's great. We can also look at glazing. So we can check this guy to compare U value 0.35, 0.3499, SIGC 0.35, 0.35, which is close enough. So that all looked great, and now we're ready to run the next step. So the next script you will run is this run parametric sim.py, and once you click on that, it's also going to open a window for you, and you just need to navigate to the content folder, BAM toolbox, parametric tool, and today's date time, and you will just be selecting these two JSON files. And you can click on open, and what it's going to do is it's going to initialize the parametric simulation. So remember, we have five categories, right? We have U factors for roof, exterior wall, exterior floor, and glazing assembly, and we also have glazing solar heat gain coefficient. So we have five categories, and we also have three measures for each. So in total, we will be running 15 measures. So what this is going to do is it's going to kick off the first simulation all the way to the 15th one, and it's just going to do that automatically without interruption. So I will just hit open, and should kick off the simulation. So for each measure, it's going to run the room load calcs first, and then system load calcs, and then energy simulation. So as you can see, this message here is saying it's currently running the room loads, and then it's just going to finish and run the system loads, and just going to keep going. So room loads, it's complete. It's running system loads. So this whole process is going to take a while because we have 15 measures, and that's the whole point of running a parametric simulation, because we wanted to finish everything all at once, and then we should have all the data for analysis. So I'm just going to walk away, and I will be back once everything is finished. All right, so looks like all the simulations are finished. So let's go to Vista Pro first to check and make sure we have received all the results files. So looks like they're all in here. So we're ready for the final step. So come back to VE Python Scripts Navigator. We just need to run this export bulk results.py. So let me go out of Vista Pro first, and then let me click on that. And this is going to open a window for you again, and it will directly be in the Vista folder. And all you need to do is just select all the results files and hit open. So now the script is going to loop through all the results files and extracting data from them and compile everything into a spreadsheet format. Once it's down, it will prompt you to open Content Manager. And it's not going to load here because it's a spreadsheet format, but you can always open it externally. So it's going to be opened within Excel. And as you can see, we have got 15 results files in here and all the data for those. So now we can go ahead and do, you know, put together some graphs and tables and do some data analysis with them. So yeah, that's all. And I hope this gives you guys an idea of what our parametric tool can do. It definitely helps speed things up and save a lot of effort that goes into parametric analysis. And yeah, we will continue developing the script. And for more content, please check out our website, tools.0me.com. Thanks for watching.